Two dead, while at least six others were injured after a fireworks factory exploded in Cabuyao, Laguna on Thursday. The explosion also caused a fire that reached the first alarm before it was put out at around 4:30 in the afternoon. The injured individuals were reportedly in critical condition and are now receiving treatment. Authorities, meanwhile, are still investigating the cause of the explosion. Local authorities said the factory had a license and had been operating for two decades before this incident. A recent study has revealed the presence of extremely small plastic particles in samples of milkfish, locally known as bangus, in the southern Philippine province of Agusan del Norte. We have more from Rafael Bosano.
Dozens frequent this Quezon City eatery every day. With limited staff and the sheer volume of clients, they have found a way to quickly push out orders while cutting down on washing dishes. This involves using plastic to cover their bowls.
Tinry po namin ng hugas lang po. Kaso sobrang hassle po, lalo na pag sabay-sabay po yung tao. Yung lalo na po pag sa Paris po kasi yung sebo. Kasi pag hinugasan po, hindi naman sigurado na nahuhugasan ng mabuti. O, lalo na pag madalian po yung paghuhugas.
The eatery goes through a bundle of plastic every day.
This is polypropylene plastic, just one of the many different types of microplastics seen by researchers to be ingested by several samples of milkfish in Agusan.
In a study by the Mindanao State University Iligan Institute of Technology, 30 samples of milkfish collected from Butuan City and Nasipit in the province of Agusan del Norte, 29 were found to have ingested between 5 to 10 pieces of microplastic. Microplastics are extremely small plastic particles. They're not visible to the naked eye, making them easier to be inhaled or ingested. The results of the MSUIIT study is not new. In 2019, the Ateneo de Manila University recorded the presence of microplastics in water, sediments, oysters, and other fish species in Tikalan, Batangas. An expert explains how microplastics end up inside our bodies.
Sa tubig, it can get broken down into small pieces, yung mga tinatawag natin na microplastics. Ito'y kakainin ng mga maliliit na ng mga yamang tubig, gaya ng mga zooplankton. It will move up its way, no, to bigger fishes hanggang sa makarating siya sa ating mga palengke, sa ating mga supermarket, and eventually sa ating mga hapagkainan. And eventually, no, itong mga microplastics na ito ay maaaring pumasok din sa ating katawan.
Experts admit evidence on the adverse effects of microplastics to human health is lacking. But for Dr. Hernando Bacosa of the MSUIIT, one thing is certain.
Pwedeng dumikit doon yung mga bacteria, pwedeng dumikit doon yung mga viruses, mga pesticides. So yan po yung pinag-aaralan namin ngayon.
It's only a matter of time, no? Kung saan makikita talaga natin na talagang magkakaroon ng epekto ang mga microplastics na ito sa ating kalusugan.
Despite this, the Philippine Health Department says consuming seafood is still safe.
Wala tayong sinasabi na huwag siyang kainin. The clear health advice here is huwag tayong magtapon ng plastic.
Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
Some bad news for consumers. The prices of cooking gas jumped on the first day of February. The cost of liquefied petroleum gas, or LPG, increased by as much as 95 centavos per kilogram. This means that cooking gas now retails at 930 pesos to over 1,000 pesos per 11-kilogram cylinder. Regasco President Arnel T. cited the rising contract prices in the international market for the movement of local LPG prices. Meanwhile, the start of the month also not looking good for motorists. This as a fifth straight fuel price hike looms next week. Diesel could see the biggest jump of as much as 1 peso and 53 centavos per liter, while kerosene is expected to jump to a peso and 9 centavos per liter. Gasoline may also see a 1 peso and 3 centavo price hike. Industry players expect pump prices to remain elevated in the coming days. The Philippine Economic Zone Authority has approved a total of 2.2 billion pesos in investments from 12 new and expansion projects. This is lower than last year's 6.4 billion. PEZA says the projects include 7 Ecozone export enterprises, 4 IT enterprises, and 1 facilities enterprise. It adds the approved investments are expected to generate $69.6 million worth of exports and generate over 1,300 jobs. PEZA is confident it can secure more investments in the coming months. From Pezel, let's move over to gaming. Revenues of the Philippine gaming operator or regulator PAGCOR surging by nearly 35% to 79.4 billion pesos for 2023, while bottom line jumped more than 50% to nearly 7 billion pesos from just 4.5 billion the year before. The agency's biggest revenue drivers, still the licensed casinos in the country's integrated resorts, which contributed over 45% of the income from gaming operations. This was followed by the surging e-game sector, which includes e-bingos and sports betting. Offshore gaming operations, meantime, also raked in some 3 billion pesos for PAGCOR. Last month, PAGCOR said the industry's gross gaming revenue went up by 33% to 285 billion pesos for the full year of 2023. That is the highest record to date. BMI, a Fitch Solutions company, keeping a more positive outlook for consumer spending in the Philippines over 2024 as the economic recovery feeds through to strong real consumer spending growth over the year. It expects household spending to grow 6.3% year over year to a value of 12.8 trillion pesos. BMI, citing economic growth, normalizing consumption levels, easing inflationary pressures, and a solid labor market to form the base for stable consumer spending. However, it did note risks to this outlook as an over-reliance on remittances, which will fluctuate from external market conditions beyond the consumer's control, and more aggressive economic weakness, which will weigh heavier on household purchasing power. BMI is now expecting inflation to move downwards this year to average 3.9%, which is already within government's target range of 2 to 4%.